Hey guys, and welcome to another video. In this one, we'll take a quick look at how to change the pivot point of our static meshes. Sometimes the pivot point of the object is not where you want it to be and can create problems in scaling, moving, and rotating it in the scene. Of course, you can go back to your modeling software and after you change the pivot point, re-import the file again, but you can do it here in Unreal 2, so there is no need to go back and do the exporting and importing again. The fastest way to do it is just to select the object, hold Alt and press your middle mouse button and put it wherever you want. The thing here is that the new pivot point location is temporary and when you do something with the object, it jumps back to its default location immediately. In order to fix the new pivot point location, you need to right click on the object before you do anything with it and here in the pivot menu, hit Set as Pivot Offset. Now as you can see, it's fixed and doesn't go back to its default location after I'm done with it. Here you have a couple of additional options. You can reset the pivot point to make it go back to where it was. If you don't want to choose the pivot point's new location by hitting Alt and middle mouse button, you can just right click wherever you want the pivot point to be and then hit Set Pivot Offset here. Next, you can hit Set as Pivot Offset to fix it. This is a quick and easy way to change the pivot point, but keep in mind that it does not affect the static mesh itself and it only works on the actors in the scene. As you can see, when I drag the static mesh into the scene, the pivot point is still in its default location and is not changed. If you want to change it permanently, just go to the modeling mode and here in the transform section, select pivot. Now you can place it wherever you want and after you hit accept, you can see that it has changed it for the static mesh itself. These are the two ways you can change the pivot points of the objects and you can choose one of them based on your project and what you want to do with the assets. For example, if you want to use the mesh in the foliage mode, you should use the second method because it's going to reference the static mesh itself and it doesn't care about the actors placed in the level. But if you're just using them in the level and don't want to reference the static mesh itself, you can just go with the first method. Yeah, that's it for this video and I hope it was useful for you. If you liked it, don't forget to leave a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel. Thanks for watching. See you in the next one.